individual stand, please? I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. Those who believe in me, even though they die, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning. Would you please be seated? A very warm welcome, and a thank you so much for coming to today, for your love and support and prayers that you've shown Anya and the family at this time. We'd like to invite anyone who would like to join us for refreshments at the bar afterwards. I would particularly like to thank the Reverend Simon Grigg, the rector here at the Actors Church, for letting us hold Pete's funeral and Thanksgiving service here today, right in the middle of the community where he worked and shone. There's never an easy time to come and say goodbye, especially to our loved ones, Pete. Pete was the person who taught me to wear a pair of heels on my sister's wedding. He was the one who tried to wind me up by putting a wood lice in his mouth, told me that it tickled, and then accidentally swallowed it. He was also the one that, when I fell over and hit my head on the coffee table, told me that I had lost 7 years of my life. I'm not sure whether he was a brilliant actor or I was just that gullible. Rarely ever called by my real name, it was either Jemima Elizabeth Puddleduck House Squeaky, or more commonly known as Skidmark. Or when Mum and Dad had their posh mates over for dinner, it was just Mark. Pete was kind and funny, witty, a beautiful soul, generous and an incredible actor. An amazing cook, stupidly opinionated about the size of Branston pickle, with a large heart and this twinkle in the eye. I, like you, could tell you a million different stories about Pete, and I bet we will too in the coming days or for a drink later. We come together today to celebrate the life of Peter Howe, a son, husband, brother, actor, friend, and so much more. We're here to give thanks for his life among us, mourn his leaving us, and honour his life and death, and commend him to God and comfort one another. Today comes with particular sadness. So today is going to be difficult at times as we come to mourn and give thanks for Peter, and there are no particular magical words to say. I'm particularly mindful of you, Anya, and our mum today who can't be with us. Our prayers today are especially with you. We're all here to pay tribute for all that Peter has meant to us and remind ourselves of all that he meant to God. As we seek the strength and comfort of God, let us take a moment in silence to bring our confusion and sorrow and lay them before God. Jesus said, "Come to me, all who are heavy burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart. And you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light." Let us pray. God, our comforter, You are our refuge and strength, a helper close at hand in times of trouble. Help us to hear your word, that our fears may be dispelled, our loneliness eased, and our hope reawakened.